Welcome back to Fifth Crow Farms orchard, primarily an apple orchard here. And I'm standing next to some of our trees. These are a few years old, haven't grown quite as much as we'd like to occupy this space. But as you can imagine, these are on a dwarfing rootstock. We want them to not get super big so we can do most of our work from the ground. And that also, the decision to go with dwarfing rootstock informs our irrigation decisions, because these roots aren't able to go really deep and get water from deep down in the water table. So we have to treat them, we kind of treat them as a crop that needs water weekly. And what we've done for our irrigation, because the roots do spread out a bit and you kind of want to moisten everything underneath the drip line of the foliage, and maybe in this case, because we're encouraging them to grow more, we want to encourage even more growth out from there. So what we've done is gone with a micro sprinkler, which keeps a stream of, or a mist really of water in a diameter that's a little bit wider than the width of the tree's foliage. So it gets wet out here too, but that gives us really good uniformity, and it allows us to water shallowly where all the roots are and encourage those roots to be healthy. But it keeps the water low enough that we don't get water up into the foliage. We are in a fairly cool climate in the summertime, and you can see today we got gray skies, and actually it's misting a little bit. So we're already getting enough moisture in our foliage, which can cause disease problems without us adding water to it with our irrigation. And we don't have really crazy hot days. It's quite temperate and pretty cool in the summer, so we're never really forced to think like, oh, you know, it's July, we got to water twice as much as we normally do. But we kind of think about replacing about an inch of water a week. And so with this particular system, which I really like, because, and unfortunately I can't get these risers anymore, but this is a product from Nelson, where this will pop up when it's pressurized and then send out the water then. And that's good because it prevents little bugs from crawling in the tiny orifice and causing problems. And we find that these, so long as we don't step on them and break them, do a really good job of lasting a long time. And then they do a good job of giving a nice uniform irrigation to the area where the roots are growing with these apple trees. And they do have these little spaghetti hoses coming from the poly. None of this stuff is super strong and durable. So that's one of the problems we have is breaking this stuff. We do actually come in here a couple times a year to weed the area around the trunks by hand. And we spread compost and mulch on top of that surface, trying to suppress the weeds, but then we add the water and the weeds come back. So we are looking at hopefully innovating by getting not only a permanent ground cover in the alleyways, but a low growing, something that hopefully contains some legumes, but we'll see how it does. I worry about it growing too high and becoming a bridge for pests and disease onto the trees. But we are hoping to move away from having to weed our kind of our tree path every year or multiple times a year. It's a lot of labor, and it is a way in which we often cause problems with our irrigation system. And we water these kind of starting as soon as the soil starts to dry down. We'll be testing the system in late March, early April to make sure things are working. And then in this climate, we usually don't have any rain after April. So we're watering these pretty steadily through May and all the way through the time when there's fruit harvestable on the crops. And because we are growing multiple different varieties and some of them with different maturation rates are right next to each other, we're typically just watering everything all the way through through when the last fruit is being harvested. So that takes us all the way into when the rains begin here in October. Back to the part of the reason for the micro sprinklers, I talked a little bit about how the roots of these trees are spread out and relatively shallow. So that's kind of why we prefer this. A really durable drip irrigation would probably require a lot less maintenance. But the problem with that is that it really just drills the water in one location, and to try to get it to spread out as much as we'd like it, we'd probably have to water it longer than we'd ideally, and we'd be really be kind of wetting at depth in a narrow band, and I think that wouldn't encourage the life of the soil in the total expanse of where the roots can grow. And we'd get not as good a results with the apple trees. Our irrigation water comes from a creek where we do have some sediment in there. So this system does work best in our situation because of the water source. We do have an additional filter before, you know, the water is plenty filtered to go through like a rainbird sprinkler on a row crop in the field of veggies. But for these little tiny holes that the micro sprinklers have, you want to do additional filtering. So that would be something to consider, as well as depending on what your pump is running at, you need to match the pressure in the line to what the micro sprinklers require. So we have our system set up to kind of keep the main line at 50 PSI for the big sprinklers we have on the veggies, but these don't operate with that pressure. So we have buried here, there's actually a pressure reducer that brings it down to 30 PSI, and that's sort of what we need to operate this system.